Hi, I'm Ace Folds.
And I'm Marcel Dubois.
And we're here at the Taste of Metro North. We're in this great facility that houses both the middle and the high school for North Reading.
That's correct. So are you getting ready to try some of this stuff? Let's see how it's like.
Skip lunch.
Okay, we're ready. We'll let you know how we made out.
All right. Welcome to Metro North.
Okay, thank you. Pleased to be here.
Tell us a little bit about you.
Okay, my name's Jay Duffley. I'm the executive chef at Joe Fish Seafood Restaurant and Bar right here in town.
Right in North Reading?
Right here in North Reading, yeah.
Okay, great.
We have a location, another Joe Fish in North Andover.
Yes.
And then we also have our sister restaurant, The Lofts.
Oh, yes.
In North Andover as well. So
that's
those
great.
Right next door to each other.
That's
today
great.
We're serving up one of our favorite lunchtime entrees. It's our scrod casserole. Today we're using cod.
Oh, that's great.
So it's fresh baked cod with a lobster cream sauce, a little bit of jack cheese, and seasoned cracker crumbs.
Wow, that sounds great.
You get
great.
One side with that. It's a great dish. Big seller, so yeah. So we're local. My boy's right here.
Hi, boys.
I got Harley's here at the middle school.
Oh, you are?
Dawson goes to the batch, so they're here as our team. And we got Chef Kyle from Joe Fish as well.
Nice.
He's our chef
at
Joe Fish in North Reading. So
that's great.
Yeah, so we're pleased to be here.
So I'm from Teresa's Prime, right in North Reading. Today I brought a maple bourbon glazed thick cut bacon. It's one of the appetizers that we serve on the menu. Probably our most popular appetizer, and honestly it's the most popular thing here I've seen so far. People are just putting me to work today, so yeah.
Now, how many years have you been coming to this?
How many years? Honestly, this is my first year. I've been a server there for right around a year now. And I did it as a favor to both Nick Sr. and Nick Jr. I'm really happy to be out here. They're fantastic guys. So, you know, we actually have the Rotary Club meetings at our restaurant every time they come in. So
very strategic. That's an excellent.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
They look tremendous. They really do.
Are you sure you don't want to try some?
I might have to.
All right. Perfect.
Well, thank you. Well,
thanks for having us.
And do you have a specialty tonight?
We have a grilled skirt steak tostada, and we also have our house guacamole. And
great.
Both of them are very, very popular dishes at the restaurant. So,
where are you located?
We are right in Market Street.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, right in the backside, right next door to King's. We've been there for about a year and a half now. Everything's been going really well. Waiting for the patio season to open up, which should be in about 4 more weeks.
Oh, that's great.
We do have about 230 tequilas, so we have probably the best margaritas in the area.
Oh, my goodness.
It's a great place. The atmosphere is great, great staff, and we're just there. We want to meet as many people and, you know, have return customers. So.
How's the response been since you opened?
The response has been amazing. Yeah.
That's great.
A lot of people coming in over and over again, bringing family and friends, and it's been a great experience so far.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. Well, welcome.
Thank you very much.
My name is Colleen, and I'm an associate in the Reading Fuddruckers inside Jordan's Furniture. Today we have half-pound burgers cut in half. We have shredded lettuce, tomatoes, and pickles, and ketchup and mustard.
I heard you redesigned the store in Reading. Is that
we did, yeah.
How has it been? How has the traffic been? How does it, has it changed?
It's gotten a lot busier. It's a lot more open. It's a lot more comfy. Yeah.
Everything else is the same. Burgers the same and all.
We still have the same burgers. We still have the same. We have a better produce bar than before, but we still have the same. Do your own.
I have to stop by. I haven't stopped by since it's been Reva.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Traffic is good here.
Yeah. It's been good. Yep.
Is
this your first time doing this?
No, I was here last year as well. Yep.
Very good. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, how are you doing tonight? What are you serving?
We've got our New England clam chowder and our three alarm chili, both made from scratch.
Good
sauce.
Right.
Yeah.
That's great.
Thank you.
And y'all located at
580 Main Street in Reading.
All right.
This is our 30th year in business.
That's great.
Yeah.
Have you done this event before?
Yeah. Yeah, I think we've done it from the start, from the beginning. Yeah.
Yeah. It's really great.
This is a nice location too. This is nice too.
Yeah.
Great setup.
Beautiful facility.
Yeah.
Oh, I love it. Well, have a great night tonight.
Thank you very much.
Get lots of bills.
So my name is Ken Ewig. I'm from Bertucci's here in Reading. We're here at the Taste of Metro North. It's our fifth year doing this event. It's one of our favorites. It's just a great community. Serving some chicken wings, and I've got a spinach and pear salad with goat cheese and roasted beets. We're just about to roll out our new spring menu coming up really soon in the next 3 to 4 weeks, so definitely keep an eye on your emails or on the website to see what kind of stuff we have coming out to offer.
And have you been, is this the first year doing this?
Fifth year doing this. We've done this every year they've done it.
And how is the traffic so far? How do you, what do you expect?
So far, we always have a really good turnout at the with the Taste of Metro North. I don't expect this year to be any different.
All right, very good. Thank you very much. Thank you for your time. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
Have you done this event before?
We have not.
First year. Yeah.
First year.
Yeah.
That's great. So what do we have to offer tonight?
Well, today we're doing a squash and pear bisque. With cream, a little bit of cinnamon, a little bit of vegetable stock. It is vegetarian and gluten-free, but we have the focaccia bread where you can add the gluten right back into it.
That's,
if you want
oh
to.
Oh, my
yeah.
goodness. It sounds wonderful.
Yeah, good. Want to try some?
No, thanks.
Not on the job. All right, got you. I got you.
But I'll be, I may be back.
All right. Yeah. We'll
thank you.
Thanks.
Thank
thanks
you.
For saying
okay.
hi.
My name is Alan Fratty. I represent Red Heat Tavern in Wilmington, Mass. Red Heat's a neighborhood dining restaurant. It's all centered around our Josper oven. So our Josper oven is a coal-fired oven, so no gas, no electricity, 100% coal-fired. It gives our food real distinct flavor. So flavor of fire, flavor of smoke, real unique stuff going on.
Now, did you, when you originally opened, you've been open for how long?
Almost 2 years now in March, so coming up, yeah.
Because we went to the opening, and I noticed that the, did you do something to the restaurant, the inside? It seems like it's quieter. I don't know. It seemed very noisy.
Yeah, we did. We put in some noise panels, which basically separates the noise, so kind of tones it down a little bit. Yep.
You have a great menu. How is the traffic here for this event?
Oh, this is great. Yeah, we're happy to be here and hopefully, you know, build up some more business because of it. So.
Is this your second year here?
Yeah,
first?
Second year. Yep.
All right. Thank you for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
Good luck.
Take
thank you.
You got China cuisine.
Yes.
Where are you located?
We're 235 Main Street, North Bradley.
Yes. We've been there a while now.
Yeah, we've been more than 10 years now.
Yeah, you must have a very loyal following.
Yes,
yeah, we do. Have a great
following. What are you serving tonight?
Chicken ravioli that we made. I think the only place we have in Boston, around Boston area, yeah. You know, is us.
And?
It's made with the whiny chicken. And this one is the ravioli, crabby, and cream cheese, and the
pepper and chicken.
Yeah, there's a pepper chicken.
Great.
Yes.
You want to try some?
No, thank you.
We got to come back.
Come back.
Come back. Yeah, I saved you.
Well, have a wonderful night.
Thank you.
Yep, Chili's. I'm Rob Harris from the Reading Chili's up the street. So we brought today was fajitas. So we have chicken, onions, peppers, the flour tortilla and all the fixings, the pico de gallo, guacamole, sour cream, cheese, and pico de gallo? Did I say pico de gallo?
That sounds right. That sounds right.
But yeah, that's pretty much what we brought tonight, so to showcase our specialty.
Now, is this, how many years have you been doing this?
This, for me personally, this is my second year, but I guess Chili's as a whole, we've been doing it for 5 years, 6 years.
Okay, 5 years.
Unless, I don't know how long you guys have been doing it for, the Rotary.
It's been a couple years. It's been a couple years, yeah.
Previous general manager, Jeannie over there, has been with them a long time, so she said she's done it a few times with them.
Now, is this one of your, one of the popular items? Because
yes.
We go to Chili's in Reading all the time.
Yes.
This is really one of the top items.
It's one of our signature items, is that fajitas, so.
How are you keeping the steak nice and sizzling, right? Because that's usually what the...
Yeah, well, tonight not sizzling, but usually what we have is we have like a hot plate, so the girls will put the skillet on the hot plate, hit the button, and in 70 seconds it's doing that sizzle coming right out. Yeah.
70 seconds, that's all?
70 seconds, so we got a hot sizzling plate.
Very nice.
And we got to make, you know, the whole restaurant, so we only have two of them, so trying to get them out could be, yeah.
I didn't know, that's a little secret. That's,
two of them, yeah.
That's cool.
Every kitchen across the country has two, so trying to get them out.
You know that. Thank you very much.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks.
So where are the
We come from Burlington, and then North Andover, and probably Westford are the closest ones to here.
And
Peabody. Yes,
and
Peabody, yep.
That's great.
Yeah.
What are you serving tonight?
This is our roasted beet salad. So it's roasted beets marinated in mustard vinaigrette, a little bit of goat cheese, some candied walnuts, and microgreens on top.
I'm Debbie Berkmeyer, and I'm part of the White family that's owned Kitty's for 69 years. And we're serving big ziti and chicken wings and salad and our world-famous salad dressing. And we just did a lot of renovations to our restaurant. We have a beautiful new function room that holds about 130 people. We've done a couple small weddings last year. And, you know, and we serve Italian food, obviously, great seafood, and we serve a beautiful sirloin steak, 20-ounce sirloin steak that a lot of people don't know about. So we have a great range of food.
So your dressing, is it a secret recipe, family recipe?
Bottle it by the quart and the pints, so you can buy it at the restaurant. We're working on trying to mass produce.
Nice, very nice, very nice. And you've been in the same location for how many years?
69.
That's unbelievable.
We started as a really small restaurant. Now we serve, seat 750 people.
So what is your busiest night, Saturday night, Friday night?
Friday and Saturday. And Sundays are good, too. They've become very busy all day Sunday.
You offer like a brunch, too, or is it strict?
No, just lunch and dinner. Mm-hmm.
All right, thank you for your time. Appreciate it. Thank you.
I know that you're very popular. Well, thank you very much. Seems right now everyone wants the cornbread. That's the most that they're asking for tonight. I guess we're known for our cornbread, so they see the horseshoe, and that's what they want first.
Oh, that's great.
Yes, but we did bring a nice, wonderful new pasta dish that's on our menu, the veal and beef tortellacci. It's done in our tapas-style menu, and when you come into the restaurant, it's served with our house-made crostini. It's phenomenal.
And I see you're having a traditional St. Patrick's Day.
Yes. We're in our 90th year this year. Can you believe it? So what we're going to do is our Irish step dancers are going to come twice instead of once. So there'll be an early evening show and a late evening show. We'll have music. Looks like Mardi Gras in there. It is great. It is a great time, and it's family friendly.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, so you'll have to stop by. Absolutely. Learn to do a little Irish step dancing while you're there. Thank you.
I'm Wally Arsenal from Harrow's Chicken Pies in Reading. We've been in Reading about 80 years now, and we enjoy coming to these community events.
Now, how does this compare to the street fair? I know you're always at the street fair.
The street fair is a lot bigger, a lot more people, and it runs for a longer amount of time. But they're both great ways to get out in the community and meet people and say hello.
Have you done this multiple years?
Yes, I think we've done it 5 years in a row now, yes. And it's always fun.
Thank you for your time. Appreciate it. Thank you.
I'm Hubner from Oys, serve Asian fusion cuisine. Today we have a wild house rice. It has shrimp, ham, chicken, peas, carrots inside the rice, and cashew chicken.
Yeah, so Chops is an American-style steakhouse located in the Burlington Marriott. We specialize in cuts of beef. We offer about 6 different cuts of steak on any given night of the week. Our most famous is our bone-in ribeye, which has been aged in a controlled setting for 45 days. It's got some great marbling, some great taste to it, as well as our amazing sides. Our chef, Jeff, works with local farms to get all of our beef, our pork, chicken. So it's a great environment. We have live entertainment 5 nights a week.
That's great.
Today we're presenting pan-seared duck with a pineapple chutney. Thank you.
I'm State Representative Brad Jones. I want to welcome you here tonight to the new North Reading High School Middle School, and welcome Taste of Metro North here and the Reading Rotary, North Reading Rotary. Great cause, great food, great company, great friends, and it's a way to showcase the new building.
So this is a new building. So for the
new building, we've just sort of dedicated the middle school. So really, this is the first year that the eighth graders and everybody, sixth grade, seventh grade, came up here. So this is the high school started up, but it's got joint facilities, but a $120 million investment. So
it's a cool way to get the community to the new school if they haven't seen it.
It's a way to showcase. It's now, if you come by, you'll notice, if you come by at almost any time, it's almost in continuous operation with one event, sporting event, athletic event, something going on. So it's been a great thing for the community. Taxpayers really stepped up. Both in North Reading and the state helped out. So it's been a great thing. It's a great way to showcase it, as well as have a lot of our business community and restaurants come out and showcase their wares, too.
So
thanks for being here today. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Thanks,
guys.
Thank you.
We're here
from Kelly's Roast Beef.
Everybody knows Kelly's.
Yeah. Established in 1951. We're actually from the Danvers location, and these three young ladies actually are employed by us, and they also go to school here.
Yeah.
In North Reading. Right in North Reading. This is their high school.
That's high school. Yeah.
So we thought it was fitting that they came and helped out tonight, and they worked tonight, but right here at school. Right? Why not? This is a fun event.
What are you serving tonight?
Tonight we're serving clam chowder.
Big surprise there.
Big surprise. Yeah, absolutely.
And I'm sure it's been a hit.
Yes, yes, absolutely. So make sure you guys, when you have some free time, you come back and have some all clam right. chowder with us, okay?
Thank you so much.
All right, thank you.
Hi, I'm Nick Ockengay, and I work for Salem 5 Bank. This is my manager, Shelly Murray, who's very active in the Reading community, Reading Rotary. And we connect with the Rotary every year to do events like this. And we're excited to be, you know, a part of the community and, you know, meeting with everyone in town and, you know, getting FaceTime with people because we're a really strong community bank. It's been around for a long time. And the culture of our bank is similar to that community culture in Reading, so or North Reading.
Really. You find you get good good exposure here? Is this a good event for exposure?
Yeah, absolutely. This event is great. Reading Town Day, things like that, where you know there's a lot of people who really drive the community here, centers of influence that come, and we can, you know, like I said, get FaceTime with them and really show that we care, and you know, we sponsor and we do things that, you know, mean a lot to the people here in town. So.
Thank you
very much.
I'm here.
I'll tell you, I watch out for the Facebook page, the Wakefield community.
Yes.
And you have some very loyal followers on that page.
Thank you.
They love you. They say the nice things.
Well, I tell you, it's all about the food and the service first of all, Lori says.
Yeah.
And then after that, it's the atmosphere.
So, that's nice.
Well, it's a common of all three. That's what
so,
we hope.
Now, when did you first open?
November of 2012. So we're 3 years and 4 months old now.
And how's the response been so today?
A while, because we're at the train tracks and kind of like people think we're on the other side through name changes. You know, it used to be Laurie's 909 Raw Bar and Steakhouse. Now it's Laurie's 909 Restaurant and Catering because we're doing so much catering now. And that's what we're promoting
great.
Tonight. That's why we have our 50% off coupon for first time orders and so forth.
That's good to know.
Very busy. That's a good thing.
Yeah,
that's a good thing. The restaurant's doing very well too. The catering is doing well now too. We've done so well that we closed on Sundays. So now we can just do deliveries on Sunday. Yeah,
that's
very nice. Now
you
can go home by 6.
How large of a function can you?
Well, we had 110. That was for a bereavement, but you know she was like 95 years old, and it was more of a celebration. And so we seat about 74, but standing, of course, they were watching a game and everything. So we had about 110.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
So.
Well, good luck.
Well, thank you very much. Appreciate it, everyone.
All right.
Kim Manzelli. I live in North Reading. North Reading resident, and we're with the Senior Action Team. This is Rich Wallner.
Well, we literally just got started, but we're a real grassroots organization. We're really trying to organize the seniors in our town because we're there's like 20% of the people in our town are 65 and older. In 15, 20 years, it's going to be 40%. So we're really trying to do better to reach out to that demographic and do a better job.
You, what do you hope to get out of today's events? Is it just
exposure, and also we have real needs. We have committees that are going on, subcommittees, where we're trying to take real action, like transportation, housing, things of that nature. And we're trying to get people to get involved, because if we don't get them involved, we're not going to work. So
great. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
To see you here tonight.
Thank you very much.
And where is Raya's located?
All the way across the street. we're right on the corner of Park and Haverhill Street here in North Reading.
And you're not just a little store anymore, right?
Yeah, it's a little bit bigger than the old store, yes, but not. It's still not a big store by any means. But I think it's our 104th year, or we're going into our 104th year, so got a lot of history, a lot of fun.
And now, what I know that you serve food. You actually have a deli. You actually have a couple of seats.
Just a couple of tables inside. But it's a little bit of everything. That's what makes Ryers a little bit special. It's a little bit of everything. We do our own marinated meats program, and that's what kind of one of the things that we're featuring tonight. We do some baked things in the store. But we've got wines. We've got some specialty cheeses. We've got some grocery, produce. It's a little bit of everything. That's good. Thank you.
Well, have a great night tonight.
I appreciate it. Thank you for coming.
I'm the CEO of Sanborn Place Home Care and Day Services in Reading, and we service Reading, North Reading, Wakefield, and Stoneham. We have a facility. We also have a home care agency, and we have an adult day center. So We service people that are aging and young disability, progressive disease. We're featured here with our, we just do have a chef, and he is quality chef. And
nice, give free samples.
And we take care of our seniors, and we feed them well. So,
is this your first year here?
I'm actually a Rotarian also, so we've been here through every, you know, we started the Taste of Metro.
What about the overall event? What do you think in terms of exposure? How successful has it been?
It's been very successful. Every year it grows and grows, and it actually raises money for the North Reading and the Reading Educational Foundations, the food shelves and other organizations, and that's what Rotary is all about, service above self, and it really brings back, I'm going to say, around $18,000 between the two clubs we make on this event. And
great, thank you very much for your time. Thank you. Thank you.
My name's Joe. I work at the Sanborn Day and Service in Reading, Massachusetts. Jackie Carson brought me aboard to be the new food service director, and she brought me here today to display some of the new food that we're doing to let people know that we're available to the people in Reading to do off-site catering. So this is just a couple of things of gourmet food. That's a nut-free apple baklava. This is a tricolor cheese tortellini, picasso and impasto salad. And basically, I'm excited to have people eat it. And a couple people have eaten it tonight and been like, this is not, like, what is this? And I was like, well, I'm a gourmet chef, and she brought me in here to let everybody know you can get gourmet food and deliver it, you know, to your weddings, your bar mitzvahs, Sunday brunches, whatever. Whatever you guys need.
Excellent.
Is that good enough?
Very good, yes.
Yeah. Welcome to Petrotation Metro North.
Thank you so much for having us.
And tell us a little bit about your place.
Our place is Biltmore in Maine. It's at 530 Main Street in Reading, and it's a new American restaurant and bar. And we have a floor-to-ceiling fireplace, we have a lot of vintage art and collectibles, and we have a great craft beer selection, 38 beers on draft, and craft cocktails, and a scratch menu.
We're from the Reading and Wakefield School Lunch Department, so we take care of all the kids' breakfast and lunch needs in Reading and Wakefield. And
this lunch lady.
Well, yeah, I'm the head lunch lady. So we're going to start this new breakfast cart at Reading High School next Monday, the beginning of National School Breakfast Week. And so we're going to be offering three different grab-and-go breakfasts up on the main floor, which is not the cafeteria, with this new cart we just got from a grant from the New England Dairy and Food Council.
That sounds like a great idea.
I know, it's a great partnership with our farmers, our dairy farmers, and the schools, and now we're gonna be able to offer something different and get those kids who come in a little bit late.
That's so great.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity.
All right.
So try a cinnamon ring and some vegetable juice or some cheese sticks.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you, have a good night.
Thank you for the invitation, we love it here. We've been here last year, it was a huge success. So
really?
We decided to come back again.
And where are you located?
Well, you Wakefield, downtown Wakefield.
Downtown Wakefield.
Yeah. That's
great. Right on Main Street?
Right on Main Street, yes. Yeah. And we also do delivery and the takeout to Reading, North Reading, Lingfield.
Great. Thank you. What are you serving tonight?
We're having California maki, seaweed salad, and avocado maki. So all the ingredients we use is organic. So because we believe organic is healthier, so we decide to do everything organic.
Thank you.
Richie Sandling from Reading Cooperative Bank, and we just love being a part of the community, all the communities we serve, so we're more than happy to help out any way we can.
And I'm sorry, your name?
I'm Elizabeth Thompson.
And have you been doing this event? Because this is the first time in this facility, we just learned.
Yep, we've been a part of it, I think I know at least the last 2 years prior to this. I don't know how long it's been going on for, but yeah.
You have the water given out. So are you? You get like new clients? Do you get like business? Do people come up and?
We do. Yeah, we do. And honestly, just to we're a community based bank, so we love just being a part of the community no matter what.
You get a lot of customers come up and say hi.
Oh, absolutely,
Our mortgage, just so you know.
Excellent. Yeah, no, we do, and that's a nice thing is when people come up and tell us that we're their bank, and it's exactly what we look for. So
I think the thing I like about your bank is the fact that I can walk into the bank anytime and talk to the person that holds our mortgage. I can actually talk to the mortgage guy or person. Right. It's just
absolutely,
and that's exactly our goal. Is we want to be reachable and accessible to all of our customers.
Absolutely, you guys are for sure.
Good experience.
Thank you for your time. Thank you very much. Thank you.
We decided to compliment everyone's dinner with dessert.
With dessert, what a great idea! Mm-hmm. Oh mm-hmm. man.
So these are all baked and fresh fruit, everything from today. We just did all of this.
Beautiful. What a beautiful display, too.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you do the North, you all the school systems?
All five schools in North Reading, the middle school, high school. Wow. It's a beautiful new high school, so we're excited about that.
It is. It's a beautiful facility.
And the three elementaries.
Great.
So it's really nice.
Well, thank you so much.
Thank you very much to another Anna.
So, hi, we're here with Greg Johnson of the Reading Rotary, just chatting about this great event. So, Greg, what can you tell me about your thoughts on the event?
Well, this is our fifth year. It's done by the Reading Rotary Club and the North Reading Rotary Club. We got together. The first 4 years was done at the Reading Memorial High School. We started up in their main street. And after the second year, it got too big, and we moved it into the field house, and we've been in there. We've had upwards of 500 people attend the event each year. And this is our first year in North Reading, which we thought it was a great time to showcase their new school, which is beautiful, as you can see. And this Main Street's huge, so it really fit us well.
Is that what they call this, Main Street? Is that what
they call it? They call it Main Street, yeah.
So is it main shops off of the, like, what's off of this main hallway, the gymnasium?
So you've got, there's a wing that goes to their junior high. Then gymnasium, and then they have two cafeterias, one for the middle school, and then the other one's for the high school.
Two cafeterias.
So, yeah,
nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, that's great.
It is.
So are you pleased with today's
Very pleased. It's nice. We're seeing a lot of faces. I think we've got upwards of 400 people tonight. We're seeing a lot of faces from North Reading that we haven't seen in Reading, so it's nice to get them, out to help support Rotary and what we do.
Do you have a favorite? Is there a booth that you stopped at more than once like we did? Or
my favorite booth is the Rotary booth, because you can learn how to become a Rotary.
Now, you had a lobster bisque there. What was it you offered?
Right.
Okay, lobster. Okay.
Lobster tails and filet mignon. Yeah.
Must have ran out by the time I got there.
Very good. Anything else?
Well, this year we've had the most restaurants this year that we've had today, 27 restaurants here today. So it's grown every year. And the restaurants, once they're in, they come back, because it's a great community event. It's a great way to get their name out, but it's a great way to, help Rotary do what we do, which is, serve in the community.
Absolutely.
So I noticed that at least a couple of the restaurants, they were highlighting the fact that they now do catering. So I imagine this would be a great way for them to introduce that to the public.
And it's a great way for the restaurant, because it's not just Reading and North Reading restaurants. We've got restaurants from, Burlington and Andover and Middleton. So, it's getting bigger every year, which is a good thing.
That's great.
Yeah,
that's
great.
Absolutely. Great. Thank you for your time and appreciate it.
Thank you
for your time.
Appreciate it.
I know. I had a great time.
Good. I hope you're full.
Absolutely. Absolutely. All right. Thank you.
Thanks.
What do you think? Unbelievable, right?
This was a great event.
Unbelievable.
I can't believe all the vendors who were here. We saw local restaurants from North Reading, restaurants from Wakefield.
Yes, yep.
Reading,
exactly. Do you have a favorite dish? Something you tried that you thought was?
I had squash and pear bisque.
That was excellent, yes.
From the residence on Pearl Street.
The residence on Pearl Street. Yeah. It's not even a restaurant. Right.
Yeah, it's not even a restaurant, but it's great food.
My favorite was the Red Heat, caramel-infused bacon dip.
The excellent. Homemade potato chips.
Unbelievable. I've had them actually at the restaurant, and they're excellent. So,
Joe Fish was here.
Yes.
Joe Fish.
Yep.
And
yep.
They had a great scrod casserole in a lobster.
I didn't try that. Yeah, it's good. Was it good?
Very good.
Yep.
But what I was really impressed with was the range of different foods.
Absolutely.
Duck.
Oh, they had duck. I didn't see the duck.
A tuna.
It might have been across from the Dunkin' Donuts bar, which I was. It was distracting me. It distracted me quite a bit. So I think it was a great event. I had a lot of fun.
Tons of people.
Good turnout. I think it was great. So
hopefully they raised a nice amount of money for the charities.
And we'll have to come back next year because.
Oh yeah, we'll sign up for it.
We'll sign up for it again. Absolutely. All right. Thanks again.
Okay.